morning, Bala. Can you switch on the link?
Hello. Good morning. Good morning, Akhtar.
Can you switch on your video?
Yeah, why not? Screen share or the video?
Your video, first of all, we just check with your video.
Okay.
After the introduction, we can start, right? Okay. I think we have another 8 minutes time. Okay.
Okay. Hi, sir.
He's our HOD.
Hello, Dr. Bala. How are you?
Fine, sir. Good morning, sir.
So happy to see you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Online.
Okay, sir.
So I should thank BK to really fix your appointment and ensure things getting done.
Okay, fine, sir.
Just now I've gone through your brief bio.
Okay.
Ethiopia, okay, and then now, so which is the city? Are you in Muscat or Sarawak? Which campus?
I am in Sohar, sir.
Okay, Sohar.
Yeah.
So, very nice.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, did you have your lunch so far or after completing this one?
Here it is 9 o'clock now, around 8:50. So, okay. It's time to go for breakfast only.
Oh, not 2 hours, right? It's less than 2 hours.
One and a half hours, sir.
Okay, that's great. So I was with King Faisal University.
In Saudi Arabia, right?
Yeah, so my always, whenever I think of Gulf, it's 2.5 hours, the time zone difference.
Probably,
we're much closer, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, India. Okay.
But for all other Gulf countries, what yes, 2.5 hours?
2.5 hours. So that's always there, 2.5 hours.
Yes, sir.
Very good. So, how long have you been there in this campus?
It's almost, I'm completing 9th year, sir.
9 years?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. Very good.
In previous to that, I was in Ethiopia.
Okay.
There I completed 4 years.
Okay.
Right.
So, yeah. Gibson is with you or? Samuel Gibson
is in Muscat, sir. He is front of me. He was with me in Ethiopia.
Okay.
He was my colleague only. Mm-hmm. We are friend only.
Oh, okay.
The same department we were working previously. Now he is in Muscat, in Higher College of Technology.
Okay. Oh, yeah, in Higher College.
Yeah.
Yeah, very good. So, we have attracted a lot of participations across India. So we have participants from over around 18 or 19 states. So yeah, I hope this will be highly useful to everyone. Thank you.
Okay. I think the problem in your line, huh? Am I right?
Yeah. Okay. It was in mute actually previously.
Okay. 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 Just to share my PPT. There is a still one. Okay. After the Pratham address, I just joined with you. Okay.
Okay, can I share now to for testing? Is no,
yeah.
Just for only. Yeah. Is okay there?
Yeah, fine. Yes, ma'am. There is no problem in it. Fine. That's it.
Okay.
So now I am going to share with my screen. Okay.
Okay, fine.
Do you see that screen, Dr. Bala?
Sorry?
Do you see that screen?
From this side is not coming actually. Maybe because I'm sharing for that reason. It's not coming to me. I'm seeing my screen only. Let me close my sharing, maybe after that come.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Oh, it's not coming.
Yeah.
I could see your video where you see it with the
producer. Still, I'm not scanning the text.
Ah, okay then. Hello, sir. Dr. Bala, can you see the screen? Yeah, yeah, sure. Yeah, it's arrived. Yeah, I could see.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, it's Arabia. Yeah, I can see.
Can we start now?
You can start.
Yes, sir, we can start.
Welcome to today's session. Good morning. This is Dr. B. Karthikeyan, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, Bishwedwar College. Without the participants, we cannot arrange this webinar. We received around 931 participants from four different countries, including India. In India, we received around participants received from around 18 different states. So I thank you for taking time out and being with us. So first of all, I would like to and welcome our beloved principal, Dr. D. Paul Dayabharan, for gave the permission to conduct this webinar. Next, I would like to invite our HOD, Dr. K. Rajkumar, for arranging this seminar. Next, I would like to invite our resource person, Dr. Bala Dandayadabani Virasamy, who has experience around 18 plus years in teaching field around the three countries. He is the author for different books, as well as he published different journals in the peer-reviewed journals. So now I invite our HOD to address the webinar. Sir, please.
So, dear Dr. Bala.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, so thank you so much for joining us today. So we welcome you on behalf of our college and the principal, Dr. D. Valdayabharan, to this webinar. Thank you for agreeing to be here this morning and then share your expertise. So we are so much privileged and blessed to have you this morning. And also on behalf of every participant gathered here, so we extend a warm welcome to you. And next, I welcome all the participants from various states. So just I have seen the statistics, it was close to 20 participants from 20 different states. And also we have participants from Oman, we have participants from New Papua Guinea and Malawi. So thank you all participants who are from various countries, and also all the participants from various states of India. I've seen participants from Jammu and Kashmir down to Tamil Nadu. And to our surprise, the number of participants from Tamil Nadu is only 60 out of 900 and odd participants. So on behalf of everyone, on behalf of Bishwedwar College, so we extend a warm welcome to all of you. So I also thank Dr. Karthikeyan for arranging this particular webinar. So he has put in a lot of efforts to make this event really happen. So I know him, he was working for the past 1 week to materialize this event. And I also thank our IT support team and for constantly supporting us for all the activities that we do over this period of time. So this is a very unique season, I would say. It's a challenging season for everyone. And also at the same time, it has become an enabler to learn many things offline, I would say online. So without looking at face to face. Okay, so we have various meeting platforms like Microsoft Teams, we have WebEx from Cisco, we have Google Meet, we have Skype, we have Zoom, and many, many, many different conferencing, video conferencing technologies, which will make our life really simple. So we are able to meet participants from all over different states only because of these different technologies and also this pandemic. It doesn't matter. Otherwise, when we conduct any sort of events like workshops or seminars, what would we observe is we have participants from in and around Trichy or Tamil Nadu or nearby states or Kerala. But this platform has made us to really reach out to thousands of people online from various parts of the country and also many different countries in and around India. So really, these different technologies have made it has become a great enabler to meet everyone online. So coming to Bishop Heber College, Bishop Heber College is a Christian higher educational institution in South India. So it has accredited with A+ grade from NAC and is also widely popular in many different countries, as we have signed MOU with many universities in US, many universities in UK, and many universities and colleges in European states, besides a couple of MOUs from Asian countries like Malaysia, like Thailand, and so on. So really, so Bishop Heber College has made its impact for offering various undergraduate and master's program in addition to that research programs. In fact, all of our 20 odd departments are supported with the PhD research program. So we have so many different departments, so many different schools ranging from natural sciences, basic sciences, humanities, applied sciences, technology, you name anything, school of business, everything. So we are able to cater to the needy, to the underprivileged people, especially, so that could be the motto of our college. And our college runs under the dynamic leadership of Professor Dr. D. Paul Dayabran, the principal of Bishop Heber College. He's a dynamic young leader who is behind man behind all the different success stories of Bishop Heber College. I would say you could see so many magnificent buildings inside that. You might see so many state-of-the-art laboratories for science, for computer science and technology. And he is the man behind all these things. In addition to that, he is the man who is behind managing a young, vibrant student community of 13,000 students. So we are on par, we are very close to other deemed universities like VIT, like SRO. So they are maybe like 15,000 students. We are very close to all these different deemed universities. So we are proud to say that Bishop Heber College caters to the need of many different student community, not only from India, but also from many other countries. So I also thank our principal. So he is currently attending another important meeting, Airbase Food Bank. He would be happy to be here this morning to see all of you, the participants. And unfortunately, we miss him today, but anyway, so we would see him coming online probably whenever he has some time. So with these few words, I once again thank our speaker, Dr. Bala, to our base, and also all the participants from various different states and other countries. I hope, I believe this session will be a really useful session for everyone gathered here. Thank you once again.
Thank you, sir. Now I hand over to the session to Dr. Bala and I the morning. Dr. Bala, please.
Yeah, thank you very much, Doctor. I will begin now. I'll stop my video, okay? In order to improve the bandwidth.
Yeah. Okay, sir, go ahead.
Okay. Good morning, one and all person here. It's my pleasure to be with you today for this webinar on developing JS web application with the Hypernet hands-on approach. If you have knowledge about object-oriented programming with Java and web app with the HTTP protocol, this session will be added an advantage for you. I have used the software NetBeans 8.2 full version, which includes JDK 1.7, J2EE 7, Glass-based web server, Hibernate API, all together as one bundle. You can download it from the NetBeans.org website. NetBeans.org website, you can go and download. And in order to have backend support, I have Oracle Database 12c software. And let us go to the objective of this webinar. This is aimed to present and demonstrate JS Web Application. At the end of the session, you will be able to understand the basics of JS Web Application framework and UI component and component shoots. And also with managed bin, working with the managed bin converters validator, at last we will have how to connect and work with the HiveNet. So it's fully hands-on approach. Side by side, I will show you the practical things. So based on the objective, I have planned to have an outline or outcome of this webinar, which classified six categories here. First, we are going to have getting started with the JSF, which covers the foundation knowledge of JSF. And then we will go and develop, design JSF application using facelets. Once we designed, we have to deal with the data using managed bin. So we have managed bin in order to connect with the design. So to deal with the data, again, we need a validation and conversion of data. So as we planned in the fourth point. And in order to fire an event, I have planned here event handling and even with AJAX approach. And finally, we will go for hibernating approach, hibernate concept to connect with the database. In previous to start this session, I would like to make you some things to get understand. Web application framework or web framework, are they same? This is actually common technology which allows for designing any website. So it's a software framework, I can say. This helps us to design, develop any website or web services or any web resource. Every framework has its own architecture. For example, I can go, Java has JSF architecture, which is allowed or available in J2EE platform. It's J2EE platform's own framework is JSF. Let us just think about before JSF, what was there in Java? We had JSP, Java Server Pages. And in previous to that, we had Servlet. Again, the Servlet is a foundation for any internet website creations. Again, now JSF is going to be run under the Servlet container. Similar to Java JSF, there are Java-based framework. For example, I brought here a few. Spring Web MVC, Strux by Apache, GWT by Google, Vadin by Vadin Limited. These are all Java-based library, but they are all third-party framework. We think about other platform, for example, Microsoft, they have their own platform with ASP.NET. Python has many, for example, Django is famous one. PHP has many framework, for example, CakePHP. And other thing like Ruby on Rails. Not only this, but also we have several framework which gives a easy way to develop the application. None of them can be familiar with all the framework. We have to be specialized with the any one framework. Of course, I would like to go with the say JSF. That's what we are going to see today. Now we go to the first topic, getting started with the JSF. What is JSF? JSF is Java Server Pages. Java Server Faces. It is a component-based interface framework available in J2EE platform. EE in a sense enterprise edition. This JSF has three implementation of specification, which has been developed by Eclipse Mojira, Oracle Mojira, Apache MyFaces. All these three groups are developing JSF pages. They're all a bit varied, and all are open sourced and hosted in GitHub project. You can download freely their library. And when you think about all the three, there is minor changes. And I'm going to use Oracle Mojira, which is managed and maintained by Oracle Corporation. And the version I have shown here is by Oracle Mojira version. First version was released in 2004. And the second one was in 2013. We have 2.2 version, which was supported for J2EE 7. And the latest version is for 2.3. It was supported for J2EE 8, which was launched in the year 2017. EADF Faces. Oracle has another similar framework called EADF Faces. What is this EADF Faces? EADF, in a sense, Application Development Framework. faces. Now I come to the point here. JS, Java Server Faces. Here also there is a faces. What does it mean? JS framework is implemented in ADF faces. So what purpose they did this one? They, in order to improve new UI component, they introduced many new UI component, and also this ADF support for visual declarative approach, which was supported for JDE. All JDE platform development were used by visual and declarative approach. Visual declarative approach mean they will provide a window where you are going to declare all your variables, properties, attributes, everything, and the code will be automatically prepared. So the code less code will be here. And this concept, ADF faces, were introduced in J developer 10G version with 905 version, which was introduced in the year April 2004. You can remember JSF was introduced in March 2004. So in the next month, they introduced ADF faces. And the latest version of the J developer is J developer 12, which was launched in the year 2019 September. Now we have a look at the component suite. JSF has many component suite. You can find, like, for example, I brought here some few familiar framework, prime faces, I faces, rich faces, boot faces. Of course, you will find many faces. All faces are related to the component suite of JSF. We should not get any confused. Okay, this is to improve JSF component or the features. They nowadays become as a separate web framework. For example, take Prime Faces. It is from Prime Tech, Turkey company. You can find from the website their framework. It is for preparing standard website. They are user friendly to create robustness of experience application. Let's look at the Ice Faces. You can find from this website, iceface.com, Ice Faces, by iSpace sub company. They focused on developing mobile application with rich internet application. Look at Rich Faces by JBoss. You can find the specification in richfacesjboss.org. They focused moreover on UI component to support for Ajax capability and more skinning theming effect. Of course, all are going to be give more thinning or skinning effect or theming effect. Now coming to the boot phase, it is by Coder for EU. You'll find it in a bootfaces.net website. It's actually for they designed to have boot phase, Bootstrap 3 and with jQuery EA. Based on this technique, they designed to adapt a new framework, which is to support for front-end application, front-end enterprise application to make easier. So if you are going for every individual, they have many feature. Moreover, they improved the components, UI components. And I brought here few only. So these are all component suites. Now we go to the JSF architecture. So JSF is a technology. It's actually a web framework, as we discussed earlier, allows you to develop and design web applications. I said already, every framework has its own architecture. Of course, JSF is also having its own architecture called MVC. MVC architecture, that is Model View Controller. So what is the model view controller mean? The logic is separated from the presentation. So now we look at the what is model, what is view, what is the controller. Model is the connector between the view and the controller. View is the web design or the user interface. And the controller is the one who going to process the data or the user actions. So these three are the architectures. Now we go to the life cycle of the JSF. Life cycle begin when you are making client request, request from the browser. When we browse something, the life cycle begins. And when server responds to the browser, life cycle ends. Based on these two concepts, life cycle divided into two phases. One is execute phase, the other one is rendering phase. Execute phase in the sense, when you start beginning request from the browser. So that is called the first phase, execute phase. When server is returning the result or something to the browser, that is called rendering phase. Rendering, in a sense, all UI components from the server is going to be rendered as a HTML document in the browser. Now, going to the facelet. Facelet is a concept which allows to design any JSF pages. It is actually a lightweight page declaration language to prepare a view. I said model view controller. The faces are going to prepare you view. So these views are like a HTML style pages. So we will have for here XHTML page that supports for facelet tags libraries that allows you to create our pages. So this includes expression language, which helps you to connect with the controller. The controller nothing but managed bean. Managed beans are going to have our methods, actions, whatsoever the data process, everything can be connected through the EL expression language to the XHTML page. And what are the advantages what we have here in the facelet main? It has fast compilation time and high performance in rendering. Fast compilation means whenever you are changing the code, immediately it is compiled, automatically compiled, and high performance in rendering. From the server, when the data is coming to the browser, immediately or fastly it is rendered as a HTML page. It validates the expression at the compile time. Whatever the object method call you write in the managed bean, immediately it reflects to the XHTML page. It supports for usability through templating and composite component. So reusability, in a sense, we can prepare our own component that allows through templating or composite component. These two are two different broad areas. So we can have templating where we will prepare any different template that can be given to third party use, or composite component, whatever the component already available that we can enhance in the new name. We can declare as all attribute and we can improve the behavior of the UI components. And last, it provides the functionality, extendability of the component and other server object through customization. Customization, in a sense, we can able to use cascading style sheet in any component that is a new feature in facelets. Now, coming to the tag libraries, or the library what we are going to use, all the libraries are going to use by JavaX Faces. This is a package we have for JSF. And when we come to use it in the facelet, it is classified into different categories. I brought four major main library here. The first one is HTML tag-based library. All HTML page will be through H prefix. So for example, H head, H body, H output text, H input text. All will be start with the H. Moreover, this is for designing. Okay, with the help of the next one, F tag, F prefix. This is called the core tag, core library. This library will also be helpful to design design any web page. So H tag and F tag are moreover going to use to develop any pages. This, when you are going to add in the design, it automatically adds with the namespace JSF HTML. The JSF HTML in a sense, HTML tag library, JSF core in a sense, core tag library. In a core F core tag, we will have converter attribute, any other supporting adding elements, all these things are available. And coming to the next two tags, CC, composite component, and UI, user fragment, templating purpose. These two, we are not going to focus this time. So these are all additional. If you want to create your own tag libraries or any templating or composite component, that time we can focus it. Just for your knowledge, I brought here. Now we come to the second topic, that is designing JSF faces using facelet. Now we are going to start our practical approach side by side. So first thing is how we are going to design and facelet. So facelet is a rich set of classes which has its own state and behaviors. All the states and behaviors are going to be applied to the UI component. UI means user interface components. So it has several models, for example, rendering model, conversion model, validation model, and even listener model. These are all inbuilt in all the components. So rendering, it's adding the control in the browser. Conversion model, converting any data, validating any data, even firing, all are related to every user interface component. For any facelet approach, we will have JSF view. So JSF view can be added in first. This view will be the view which is going to prepare the view. Inside, we should have a form if you are going to get any input. So inside the form tag, all the input tags will be there. So input elements you are going to place. This is mandated by default for all. Okay. Some codes are there. How the codes are coming here? Hello. Now we go to see one by one all input tax. Let me first of all focus on input tax here. So in the input tax side, we have text input area, input hidden, input secret, input file. So these are all the input tax. The difference between the text and text area, you might know these things already. So this is what text area is for multiple lines of input we are able to get. Text is single line text. Hidden. If you want to pass any input that secretly inside the web page, we can follow this input hidden. Secret is going to be useful for getting password. Input file, any document, file, photographs can be uploaded to the server for that purpose. Let me go to the window and I will introduce the IDE. This is the IDE that I use here. You will find a project area. You'll find a project area. I already had two projects here. I already prepared. I will show you how to prepare. There is a service area where you can find a database. There is a server area. Just for your understanding, I'm showing. I have here a GlassFish server. You can use either GlassFish server or Apache server or any other server. I have configured here my database. I configured here. This is the Oracle database here. I used to Scott schema. I already prepared a table here. We will use this one later. Okay. So now I will show you a simple step how to create the project, and I will show the input. This is for your understanding how to prepare a project. Okay. So click on the new project, then choose Java web application. Now you are going to choose your location where you are going to prepare your project, and you are going to name your project. And we are going to select our server, which web server you are going to use, Apache or GlassFish. I'm using GlassFish. And here you will find the frameworks, Spring MVC, JSO framework. I'm choosing JSO framework, Strux, Hibernate. Hibernate also, if you need, you can select here. It will take fraction of a minute. Okay, Hibernate also I selected. It is asking which database you want to connect. We are going to choose now. No worries about this one. We can also connect this database here because we have in Hibernate, we have configuration. I will show you later. So I'm just selecting now. I'm just going to finish because I want to show the library what I connected here. Here is our web application, newly created one. Now you can see, just for your understanding only, I'm showing the Hibernate library is added already. GlassFish library added, JDK 1.8 is added. And this is our configuration well, because I added Hibernate, so it is coming. I will show you the steps to create later on 6th point. So we have your index file by default, it is prepared here. So you can look at this one. This is by default code up to body tag they gave. Here are we going to make a code. And to prepare the code, you can say right click here. We can choose insert code. And then we can choose JSON form, which automatically prepare the tags for view and the form. Now we are going to put all your input control inside. Let me introduce the library. Start with the H colon. Automatically, it pop up all the tags available. These are all H tag related. For example, if I'm going to have F tag, all attack related. So it is very easy to learn. For example, if you are going to have any tag, I'm going to have H, we have seen input tag. For example, I say I, and the pop-up is not coming. In a sense, control space where you just press, it will show pop-up all the tags. Now, for example, I'm taking input text. You just press the space bar and it will produce all the attributes. So without even knowing, we can find the attribute, and also it is providing the meaning of the document. The document is also there. You can also see that one and we can learn it. These are all for your understanding. I will not type every code because our time limit is less. So I will directly go now to the presentation. I already prepared input. Let me show you what I prepared here as input. Input tag, I included all here. I had a form. In form, I have input text. I have secret. I have text area here. I have file. I have hidden. Hidden, we cannot see in the page. Okay, let me demonstrate this one. Okay, input tag. Let me refresh it. Input. So these are all the input we saw. Input text. This is a password secret. This is text area. So text area will produce multi-line. This is for input file. You can load any document file here. You can choose select input document. Okay. So the same way we are going to see all the library side by side. Let me go to the thing. So every control or the tag library has many attributes. For example, I am discussing about the input tag. So every tag has its own ID. So we are going to fill the ID, and every tag will carry the value or related attribute. For example, I put hash curly brace inside. I am saying user.name. For example, this is EL, expression language. So this user is a manager bean, in which we have the name is an attribute or the variable. So this way only we are going to connect the manager bean with the XHTML face or facelets. So for example, label I have here. What label you want, you can mention. Label, of course, separate things are there. And it is for representing for this text. So you can also use the other control. Maximum length of input, size of the control. Alternative text, read only. If you want to make read only true or false, you can make it. Read only false mean you can type. Otherwise, if it is true, you cannot edit or type. Required input, you can say true. Means it is a mandatory field. If it is mandatory, if user is not typed the value over there or choose the value, so immediately the required message will be there. For example, I'm saying the username is required. And this required message is mandatory. We can deal with the two way. One is this way. The other one is through the validation parameter. I will focus on later. And this is a validator message. Any validation message coming mean we can pass through this one. Or we can pass through the message dialog. There are way. And for every individual component, we can go for styling attribute. So cascading child sheet can be added here. For example, I say color, red color. You can say. Otherwise, as a common, we can also include as a cascading style sheet separately. And for every component, we can access through the key. Access key, for example, I say Q. If I press a Q, it immediately goes to the text field. So these are the way that we are going to see. Every tag attribute have a tags are the having attributes with the values. So we are going to, if you are knowing all these things thoroughly, and then it is very simple to work with the JSF application. Now I will go to the output UA component. We have output label, we have output text, we have output style sheet, we have message, we have messages, plural, graphics image. So let us look at the label and text. Label is going to be associated with every input component. Output text, in a sense, it is going to just print the text. Both are going to display the text, but the output text simply print whatever the texts are assigned there. But the output text is going to have an association with the input field. Output style, in a sense, it is allowing you to connect any cascading child sheet in your web design. Message and messages. Message, in a sense, it is going to give you a warning message for every individual component. Messages, in a sense, as a common message for all the control, at the bottom is going to give a collective message. The last one is a graphics image is allowing you to load the pictures. Now we'll go to the design. So I just brought here output text here. Output text, I'm simply saying, please fill the form. So it's output text. I'm going to say output label. So output label, in a sense, I'm going to say the attribute far. Far means far, I'm saying TP. So this far value will be representing the ID of the input where you are passing. So I said a label is associated with the any input. So this is also the label is associated here with the text box. So I say in the label as a value with the enter the name, and the far is represent TP. What is the TP? TP is the ID of the text input. Similarly, I put pass. It is related to input secret password. Label here, I say text area TA. Input is ID with the TA. So similarly, I have given all. So with the previous, I included. What component we saw previously, I included. I'm just clicking here for your understanding. So here, this fill form is by output text. All other display are through the label. And I incorporated the previous input control. This is input text, this is secret text, this is a text area, and then this is file. And now we go to the next component, that is button or link. In button or link, there are a few more available, but I brought the important one, especially command button, command link, and output link. We have three important things. The command button, in a sense, it is going to submit the value to the application, and it is action-based. Command link is going to link the another page, and it is also action-based. And we have output link is going to link another page also, and we should see the differences here. So what is the action-based in the command button and command link mean? Both are action-based, but button is only going to submit the form value to the application. But command link is going to link the pages within the application. But coming to the difference between the output link and the command link, output link is not action-based, but the output link able to connect external links. But it is also going to connect internal or external, but command link only for internal within the site. Okay, now let me show you the simple example. I have here a command button. Just I'm submitting. I'm using type as submit. I don't have any value to submit here. That's why I'm keeping like that. I have command link. I used action with index. I'm not given .xhtml. It is not mandatory. Even if you give xhtml, it will work. So in button also, we are going to give action attribute. In future, we will do it. And coming to the output link, in the value point, we are giving the URL or the page which you want to connect. And in between the beginning and end of the tag, we are going to represent our label. There is no label value for this one. The other components have value. This is a label that is going to show. But here the value is the one which is able to connect. Now we go to the button and link. I press the button. I don't have anything to submit. Just it is pressed. That's all. I have home. It will go to the home page. Again, I come back here to the button area. Click home. This is by output link. Same thing. Okay, let us go to the next one. Select input UI component. In select, we have list box, we have menu, we have checkbox, we have radio. So in list, we have two different lists. One is select many list, the other one select one list. Select many list by name itself, you could have understand. Many item can be selected. Multiple item can be selected. Select one. One item is allowed to select. So for that reason, they separated two different tag library here. And similarly for menu, same as select many. Many menu can be selected. And one menu, separated. And here we have many checkboxes. Many checkbox will be provided. We can able to select one or more item. And there is this is newly given here, select Boolean checkbox. Boolean checkbox, in a sense, only one checkbox is given, in which you are selecting or not, especially when you are going to have remember password in the page, or you're going to have an agreement. If you agree, we will proceed to the next. In that situation, we can able to use Boolean checkbox here. And the last one is select one radio. We will provide radio button, one among them we are going to select. For example, male, female category, we are supposed to select only one. Now I'll show you the code. This is related to select input. So in select input, I called F tag. So F select item. The select item is a supportive tag to add the element. So to add the element, I'm going to use select item. Select item has two important attributes, that is item value with the what is the value that you are going to process. Item label, what the item label that you are going to display in the page. So based on that, I say four item. The same four item I used in the many list box, one list box. Similarly, I went for the same item in many menu, one menu again. I used in the checkbox again, many checkbox, and for one I cannot give many. So this is for Boolean checkbox. I say, for example, remember me. And for radio, I give two item only. So let's look at the design, the output. So these are the control that we prepared. Now you see this is many item. How do we going to select the many item? You know that by pressing the control key. So we are able to see many item here. But when you come to look at the one item in the list, even if you press the control key, we may not be able to select the item. So these are a list box. Similarly, this is for menu item, mini menu. Menu is going this way, you see. This appearance is different. Now I select, press control key down, select the second item, select third item. I'm not selecting fourth one, you see, not selected. Go back. So this is for selecting many menu. And here, select for one menu. Is selecting only, allowed to select only one item. This for checkbox item. So you can select or deselect it. And this for only one, especially useful for remember me function or any agreement. This is for radio button here. You know, these are component, something is new. For example, the appearance is new here. And almost what we are using in other UIs, similarly they brought here, but with different names, that's all. Now we go to the UI component with panel. Panel grid is going to prepare your UI component in a table structure. Of course, we can use HTML table to prepare or align your control. So to lay out your control, either you can use HTML. That is, HTML code is too lengthy. Sometimes, you know, HTML table row, table row, column. We are supposed to arrange all the rows and column in a way that we need. And if you simply need any row and column, we can follow panel grid. Panel grid, we are going to say, number of columns. So column number one mean one column row will be prepared, two column row will be prepared. So for that reason. And panel group is going to group all your UA control together, but this will not be visible in the facelet or the design view in the browser. But internally in the code, we can understand that these are all one group, the other parts are other groups like that. And we can see the table, data table. Data table is to represent or show your records or the data item to present in the HTML form to show the data we are going to use it. This is for presentation purpose. For example, I'm reading the record from the database table and I want to present in the web page. We can use data table and we can collect all the records and put it in an array or list value, and we can add it. Old days, what we did is we will select it and we use that HTML tag form, and we should represent which column, which row, and we have to use the looping. So many pain were there, and now it is very simple. We are going to give an array value to be connected with the data table, and the data table will ask what are the column. We just specify the column with the attribute, and no looping, nothing. It is going to simply bring all your data and present well. And now I will show you the panel grid. And later I will show you the data table after finishing the manager bean. Now go to the panel grid. In the form, I have a panel grid here. I said the column as 2. So here, the same thing, I put name, address, password, something, photograph, what are the basic input we had, all input I put inside. Now I am going to execute and show you. So panel grid. You see, it is aligned well. And now the layout is fine. Previously, when I look at the old one, I gave input text, it was not aligned. Of course, it is only one document. Let me show you the output tag. You see the output tag, it is going zigzag way. It's not feeling happy to work with. Now, if you come to the panel grid is aligned well. So it's looking nice now. It's happy to work. Okay, so what we did is simply we called the panel grid and we said number of column only and we put all our control inside. That's all. So moreover, very easy to work here. Now I'm going to the third topic, that is managed bean. So how do you going to use managed bean? What is the managed bean? So in any project, we can have one or more managed beans. Managed beans are the POJO. POJO in a sense, plain old Java object. Plain old Java object in a sense, what we learned in object-oriented programming as constructor, getter method, setter method, or we can say mutator, assessor. So mutator, assessor, the getter setter method. So all these methods are going to be, this is actually entity bean, what we used in EJP. The same thing, they brought in the new name as managed bean. So managed bean as annotation is managed bean. So this managed bean is going to be associated with any user interface component in the XHTML page. What is the work of this managed bean actually? This is going to validate any component. Of course, validating the component, validating any data can also be done in HTML page itself, or you can do it in managed bean here. Or it's important that when you're going to fire any event handling mechanism, all these things are going to be done here only. Or you want to process any data, processing of data, coding part, all will be here. Or you want to provide the navigation. Of course, navigation can be done in two ways. One, you can do it in the managed bean, or we can complete within the XHTML page itself. Of course, the previous one button, and I was showing button, command, output link. Output link and the command link were showing connected within the XHTML page itself. It was not coming to the navigation of the managed bean. Now only we are starting managed bean. Here also we can make a navigation to connect. And special information about this, the managed bean is actually a lazy one by default. It will not start immediately. So what we have to do is, we have to make the managed bean to be eager. Eager in a sense, there is an attribute called eager. We have to say eager equal to true. So it's an annotation here, add to managed bean. We are going to say name equal to your object. If the object can be anything. And eager is true in a sense, it is going to make the managed bean active. So this object will be used in XHTML to access all the attribute or the variables through the expression language. Now coming to the managed bean, we have several scopes. So these scopes are very much interesting and very useful. Let us focus on application. Application in a sense, we are going to say at application scoped. When you are using this application scope, all the user in the application will be able to see the data that you handled. All the user, for example, your application server is running, your web server is running. From the entire part of the world, they try to access web page. So whatever the data you share, all the data will go to all the people. For that reason, they're given application scope. Session scope, meaning you can make n number of requests, multiple HTTP requests within the browser. Within your browser, you can make n number of new tab. In all the new tab, session scoped value will be coming. If you declare session scope, the value will be coming to all the tabs if you open. Once browser is closed, the data value will be closed because session is closed. View scoped in a sense, it will be showing within a single page. It won't go to the next page. Okay. So next page means the data will not be stored. That's important. For if you have any scenario like that, if my scenario is expected to show the value within the page, the data should not allow to go to the next page. At that time, you have to use a view scope. And the last one is request scope. Request scope means as like a session, but session has multiple requests. Here it is for only single request. For single request, you are going to use a requested scope. Apart from this, there is a none scope. I don't want to represent any scope, meaning we can say none scope. There is another one more called custom scope. We can also prepare our own custom tags. Using that also, we can prepare our own scope. So let me show the demonstration about this one. It will be very much interesting. Let me go to the code. I'll go to the manager bin. I have given here input manager. So input manager is my design. I have here grid panel like what I had previously. And I am getting here author ID. I have name, I have phone number, and I have a button to submit. Submit the value. This is my design. So to this value, I have prepared already the manager bin. I will show you the manager bin. I prepared here in the source package. I have here the user bin. I have many bin here. Let me show you the user bin. It's prepared for dealing with the input. So I put all the tags here, all the scope here. Especially at present, we have view. I will show you the view. Later, I will show you the other one. And in the manager bin, I have mentioned here, manager, my name, bin name is u. So you, using this u only, I'm calling my attribute here, u.username, u.location, u.phone number. Now you see here, I have username, phone number, location. So there is a default constructor, and I have getter setter method. So need not to worry about preparing getter setter method. It can be automatically prepared if you have right click over here. Just declare your variable. Declare your variable. After declaring this, you just right click over here, say insert code, and then there is a getter setter method appear here. Constructor, because insert getter setter already finished, so it is not showing. If you want, I will show you. I will just delete it. I will delete all the getter setter method. I'll make once again here, right click, insert, go to getter setter. There is a getter setter method. You choose it. And what are the variable you want? I am going to select all because I want all the getter setter method. See, it generates automatically and quickly. So you see, if you want constructor again, you can prepare. Also, everything is prepared automatically. Now, this is our manager bin. So manager bin means we put extra code that apart from the object oriented technique POGIO, we added the annotation name with the eager. That's all. And we have a scope. At present, I have a view scope. Let me go to the design view. I'm going to the manager bin. I have input other number. For example, I say 12345. I'm going to enter my name. I'm giving sample phone number. Okay, I'm going to submit it now. Okay, the value is appearing. Okay, value is appearing here. I asked to print the value here. It's showing. I have given a link here to show the result in the next page. If I'm going to the next page, the value should not come because I have given view scope. See, the values are not coming. Now, I will go to the other scope. I'm going to comment this one. I'm going to use session. Session, in a sense, multiple requests can be done. Multiple HTTP requests. Once you are saved, automatically this is going to be deployed. You can see here. Once the deployment is done, we can come here. And I'm coming back. I'm starting here again. Because it's deployed once. Again, I'm starting. So I'm going to give the value like previous. I'm going to give my name, for example. I'm going to give some phone number. And I'm going to submit now. So value submitted. Now this is a session scope. So if I'm going to the next page, so next page value is coming. The same way, if we are going to copy this URL, I'm going to open a new tab. I'm opening a new tab, and in the new tab, I'm just pasting this URL. Yeah, still the value is coming. Now, for example, I'm going to open another browser. I'm going to open Firefox. In the Firefox, I place this URL. So the value should not come here because it's a session application, session scope. So values are not coming, but the components are there. Now I want to bring the data in the another browser. I'm working with the Internet Explorer here. I want to bring the data in another browser. Meaning what? If your server is located in some area and people from entire world is accessing to this one, that means I'm going to use application now. Whatever the value I entered here will come to the another browser. I will show you now. So I'm going to make application scope. Sorry. I'm going to close all other. I'm again saving. Again, it's going to be deployed. Getting deployed. Okay. Now I'm going to give, I have two browser already, I told. Yeah, this is Internet Explorer. This is Managed Bin. From the Managed Bin, for example, I'm going to refresh it. I mean in the Firefox. The Firefox, I'm going to enter the value. For example, I'm saying 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, I'm giving. And I'm going to give maybe another name. Okay, I'm going to give input. I'm going to submit it. So value is submitted in the Firefox browser. Now I am coming to the previous browser. If you are going to refresh here, because it's old one. Now you see what I entered in the Firefox is arrived to the Internet Explorer. This is application based. So the entire application with all the user will share the value if you have given application scope. So this is the way that I can give clarity to the scope of the managed bin. Now we go to the fourth point. So fourth point is validation and conversion of your data. The data, whatever that we entered, are not valid usually. And before we take to process, we have to validate whether the data is correct data. So for that reason, there is automatic conversion is there, converter. We can use the converter to convert and take your data automatically, or we can use a validator to validate the data. So now we first of all focus on the converter. Java provides several classes for the converter. All converter are available in JavaFX convert package. You can use by converter ID or you can use through the tags. Okay, that tags are allowed to use. Now I'll show you the tags. Okay, tags are fall on three different category: F converter, F number, F converter convert date and time. So three different classification. We can use converter mean it is going to call converter ID. Converter in the sense you are going to call converter ID. So many converter IDs are there, but it is actually a class name where you are going to connect. JavaX faces dot and then the converter that you want. I want a double here, so you can put double. You want an integer, put integer. So in this way, you can call any type of data that you want to convert. And if you want to have a percentage, that we can call through the convert number. And you are going to specify type as percentage. Percentage sign we can put and it will convert automatically to the percentage. Convert number I'm going to give for currency. So I say currency, what is the symbol that you want? I want a dollar. Currency symbol, I want a dollar. And type is a currency I'm going to specify. And if you are going to have a pattern, you want to specify, I want 3-digit with the dot after decimal 3 point I want. You can specify like this. Minimum fraction of digit. What is the minimum fraction of digit you want? You can specify like this. Date and time converter. What pattern of date and time you want? Date, date, month, month, year, year. Or month, month, date, date, year, year. Whatever the format that you give, it will be taking automatically to that one. Now we go and see the code, converter. So I have given here converter I connected with the bin. So converter for double, what I have shown there, for example, input text, I applied for, I'm going to get the input for, what do you call, double value in the first text box and integer value for the second one. So what I did is here, in the input, I'm not closed the input tag here. So input opened here and input closed here. You can see the yellow. In middle, I put the converter tag. So if you want to have converter validator, it must be inside the tag as a child tag. So, and what is the way that you are using here? For example, I'm using converter tag ID as double. That means I'm going to take this value as double. I'm here using, you see, within this tag, I'm going to say this is for integer. I say converter ID with integer. I'm going to do this one per percentage. So I use converter number and percentage type I'm saying. So here, currency is dollar. and type is currency. So similarly, everything is there what we discussed. So I will show you the demo. So where is the converter? Data table, I forgot to show. Actually, I have to show you that one. Okay, let me finish this one. So always give a number for double, automatically take. For example, I'm giving double. This is the double number, but I'm giving integer number. It will take automatically. But for integer, we have to give integer. If you are giving fraction point, then it shows error. Okay, automatically you'll find the error. Because integer is expected integer, otherwise it also shows a warning. Okay, but this value will be converted as to if you are giving 1 mean 1.0, it will take. For example, I'm going to give 10%. So 10% means it will convert to the percentage. What is the 10%? I will give dollar value with the, whatever the value you want. I'll give some points with some points and whatever the value that fractions you want and the date. For example, today is 6/6/2020. Okay. Now I have given almost the correct input and it is going to be processed. You see here, I gave 1.0 is taken. Okay. So it is automatically converting the data. Okay. So let me go to the validation the same way. So validation, again, like converter, we have set of classes available for validating your data. For example, F validate required. I said earlier, in every input, there is a required input. Required equal to true, you say mean, that is a mandatory. Either you can set through the attribute of the tag, or you can apply through the validation requirement using this one, F validate required. So this makes mandatory requirement. And other tags we have is validate length. You are going to specify minimum maximum length. Validate long value, long range. Again, minimum maximum range you are going to say. Again, double range with minimum maximum range you are going to specify. And there is a regular expression with the pattern. Pattern you can specify for regular expression. There are so many patterns. For example, you want to get only user name. Name is name. There is no number included. So you can filter it for email ID, for phone number, for everything we can put it in regular. This itself we can solve so many issues. And validate bean. Bean is actually going to be dealed in the manager bean. Anything you want to control as a through the coding, we can put this manager bean and it can be controlled in the manager bean aspects. Okay, let me go and show you the validator. I put, for example, name, middle name, last name, something like this, in which I have length minimum 5, maximum 8. Here for middle name, what I give? I put required field here. I put required field here and put required message here. Okay. Put here last name is I put mandatory, but not as a required. Previous one required here, but here as mandatory here, required field. So either you can follow this one or you can use this one. What you call validate required. And for age, what is the range you are going to say? And salary. Double range, whatever that you are going to specify, and regular expression for password, 6 length I want, I will have number as well as letter, and the email. You can specify email, I'm validating in the bean. This is going to be controlled in the manager bean. And phone number, I'm going to specify minimum and maximum length is 10, because Indian phone number is 10, I put like that. And I have command button here to submit the value. So all this is coming connected already in the validator bean here. The validator bean have some code here. I put here the pattern for the email. So this is email. I put the pattern here. And for name, I say some words here. We can also deal here. Okay. So either in the, what do you call, in the HTML code, I mean in the facelet or in the manager bean, you can do that. Now we can go to the view of this. So this is the one I have. Oh, this is the old one. I'm sorry. Validator. So I'm giving. I'm just pressing the button in beginning. It shows the error. Again, I have to discuss about this one. I put all the error together here. Of course, this is our next topic. I will just complete this one also. I'm sorry. I forgot it actually. I will complete this one. I will explain this one also. So JSF has two message categories. One is message, the other one is messages. So message, in a sense, a single message will be given for individual elements. So every individual element has an ID, for example, ID T1. So if you want to give error message for this, I'm going to say message for T1. For T1, in a sense, T1 is an ID for this. So if anything happened in the text box here, text field here, immediately this message will appear. And you can also specify your coloring, cascading style sheet. This is for single message. If you want to give collectively a single message, we can use messages. For example, I have here two text fields, name ID, mobile IDs, and I'm not going to specify here ID because it's common. We cannot specify all the ID. So there is no ID here. We specify as messages as a plural, and we can specify any styling sheet, and we finish. Of course, in my design, I used messages. I'll show the code here in the design. Validator, I might have used this messages. You see here, I use messages. I'm collecting all the errors, and I'm showing here, okay? So all the errors were showing because I'm not given the correct input. All the text fields were empty. Now I'm going to give the first value, just four value I'm giving. Three input. Still it says you have to enter five length. Minimum length is five. I have to enter two more letters. So let me enter first one. You see, now middle name, last name problem. We have to enter. So I'm going to enter some value for here, some value here. Okay. Now phone number, age. So at least from starting from one. Okay. So I'm giving one for example. So it's accept. So salary, at least some numeric number. I'm saying from one, wonder be nobody will work. Just for example, I'm doing here. Password. So at least I have to give six length. So I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And now. So password is gone, but I have to again enter for next testing. It is automatically going. Okay. So email. You can specify any email. Any email, I'm saying a@b.com, for example, or d.com. So one full email, and the last is phone number. I also full 10, so minimum 10 number or equal to 10 number. So I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and also 10. Total 10 is there. Now I hope it will accept the input and it will print the value here. The value is printed. So this is about the validation. And one more thing I forgot to show you is data. After finishing this manager bin, I forgot to show you the data table. Let us look at this data table. Okay, data table, I use the name, address, phone number, three fields, in which I'm going to add it into, this is the data table. Whenever I add the value, immediately it will show. Let me show the demonstration, later I will show the code. For example, I will say my name, I'm going to say I'm from India, I'm going to show some phone number, and I'm going to add. What I did here is I'm just adding as a new class with the object. So immediately it is added. So you can add n number of the records here. Okay, I'm going to add something here. Okay, so it's added. Okay, this is our data table and this is our form design. If you want to clear all the records, I'm just clearing the array value. That's all. List array only. Let me show you the value here. We have data table. So data table design, you can see the data table design here. So as usual, I have a form, I have panel grid here, I have input for name, address, phone number, and below to the form, I opened another form, and in which I'm going to connect the data table. I use data table, I mentioned here the column. In the column, we must use facet tag to represent the header. You have to use, it is mandatory, name as a header. It should be in a small letter. And within the tag, we are going to say whatever the column name you have. And you can represent the value in any output text, any controls. I used output text to display the value. Here it is connected with the manager bin. So how the manager bin values are coming? I say T dot list. List is a list value. I'm going to show you in the data table value. I prepared a list box here. List array list value here. So I prepared a list here. So this is a data table column in which I'm going to load all my value. I prepared a username, location, phone number, and the list all for getter setter method, inclusive of with constructor here. and I have a method here, add new, in which I am preparing object for data table, and I'm going to pass the value for the constructor, name, location, phone number, and with my list, what I prepared already here as list. In this list, I'm adding the value. I'm just adding the value for every time to add. And when I go to clear, this is going to be connecting the clear button. I say list.clear. That's all. Now look at the code. Look at the code here in the button. I might have connected here. So my attribute name, I have to show this one. I forgot actually. My object name for this is, I given as T. The manager bin object name is T. So through the T, I say T.addNew. So addNew, what is addNew going to do? Every time it's going to add the new class with adding a new data what you entered. So every time that data will be going to connect with the data table, and it is the second one. This is what clearing table, clear table is going to clear. Just say list.clear. Now coming to the data table, I say value. This value is my list value. Once you are given list value, mean the list is automatically loaded, but it is mandatory to have a variable with any variable. You have to access through this variable for all the attribute. We should not call T dot username here, but the data table should have the variable. Through that variable only we have to call the column field. So here there is no looping, nothing. So all are eliminated. Now simply we are representing, you can have n number of value, everything will be loaded, added easily and managed in an easy way. Now coming to the fifth point, working with the event handling and AJAX. So event handling. So event is when you are going to work with the button or links, or when you're going to have a text field or any other things to change in the menu or list value or anything, you may expect it to fire an event. So you are going to click over there. You are going to change over there. That time we need to fire an event. You have to call the procedures. So how do you go to call the procedure? The calling procedure will might be done in the manager bin. Code will be written in the manager bin. And in the event handling, we have three different type of events. The first is called action listener. Action listener, whenever you are going to click on the button, when you click on the button, action listener is going to take place. Whenever you change the value, typing the value on the text field, changing the value on the list box menu or checkbox or radio or whatever it is, they are all called value change listener. And apart from this, we have also application event. It is actually dealt with the lifecycle event. We have lifecycle with two different phases, you know that. What do you call execute phase and the other one rendering phase. This is related to system event actually. So we are going to use action event and value change event. I will show you a fraction of pseudo code here. So for example, I prepared a code in the manager bin value change. I'm going to call in the facelet as this name in any button. For example, I'm going to say value change event one object. Through this object, I can able to get any new value. E dot get new value, I'm converting to string and I will assign to any string value here. The same way you can have another method in which I'm going to have an action event. So if you want to take any value, you can able to take. Otherwise, if you are simply processing something, you can do it. For example, I'm saying welcome to this webinar. So let us see this example here in the program. I'm having here event handling. So I have form here, which is going to have a department. So here I'm loading the department. Okay, I have a value change listener. And one important thing is, previously I have shown select item. I added list value, list item. Every time I said, if you want to add a group of item automatically, that we can also load through the array list. For that we have here, where is it? There is a hash map. Oh, sorry, I have to show the another manager bin. For that we have linked hash map. So in the linked, we just prepare a linked hash map with the two string parameter. Two string parameter in a sense, first parameter for value, second parameter for label. So I have assigned your list dot put this value. Finally, this list value, I'm going to load it in the design. For example, come here in the design. I put here items. This is plural. Previously, we use singular. Values, our object. EM, in a sense, it is my event management bin. I put the name as event management being here. Through this, I'm accessing here in the facelet em.department list. So automatically this list will be loaded. This is one point. Another, I'm calling here value change listener. Whenever the value is changed, I'm calling value change. What is the value change? I've written the code in the manager bin. What is the manager bin value change? What I shown previously. Whatever the new value choose from the form, immediately assign that value. Similarly, I have action event. What I have shown in the slide, similarly, I used here. So I have a button here. I have a button here. You see, click on this button. I say I'm calling action done. So immediately what will be there? Whatever the value, when the button is clicked, the value is going to be assigned. What is the value assigned? Message value I called here. So I'm going to call this message value here. Okay. So let me show you the form. What is that? Event handling. I have here list box. I have put here your selected value. At present, nothing. I'm not selected anything. Action value is nothing. I'm going to select, for example, CS. So immediately the value is coming here. But it is by refresh, no, without Ajax. I will show you the next one as Ajax. IT, I'm choosing. SC. You see, it's done. Now I'm going to click on the button. So value is processed. Now we have done event handling approach. We go to the next one, Ajax. Ajax is stands for Asynchronous JavaScript for XML. Ajax, Asynchronous JavaScript for XML. It is a technique to use a HTTP XML object used with the JavaScript to send and receive the data from and to the server asynchronously. That is a duty of this HTTP XML document using JavaScript. And the purpose of this is without reloading the page, without reloading the whole page, any value that you want to deal with will be automatically loaded. That is a technique behind the Ajax here. And coming to the point, JSF is providing excellent support to Ajax call. So they provided a tag, F Ajax tag. Using this, we are going to implement the Ajax technique. Coming to the tag, we have F Ajax. Two important attributes are there, execute and render. Execute in a sense, what is the input component you are going to represent? That means what is the input you are going to take and render. Render is what is the output you want to show. For example, I put here form, I get the input for the name. ID is name and I'm going to get the value through the manager bin and I have a button. Inside of the button, I'm going to have F Ajax. Execute, I'm saying input, I'm going to take it as a what is the input that is given in the text box and what I'm going to render the output in the message. The message is outside the command button, I give output text as message. So I'm going to represent the same value, what is represented in the, what do you call, in the expression language here. I put the same. So what will happen now, when you press the button here, without refreshing, the value whatever I entered here in the input text will go to the output text. In the same way, without text, without command box also we can do. I will show you in the next slide. So I'm going to show without command button. I'm not going to use any command button. So I have text field here. Okay, as it is the same as name as ID, and I have passed the expression language with the user bin name. I'm going to show the value message and with the same name. And in between this, I have a Ajax call here. Apart from the execute and render, I have added new attribute that is event. Event is come up with the key up. So key up is the attribute whenever that you press or type the key in the keyboard. For example, when we are typing something in the Google search, automatically it is trying to fetch the data. It is more or less similar to that one. Whenever you type the data, immediately it is going to render the data in the page. For that reason, I prefer this one. So I will show you the demonstration. You will understand better. I'm going to the Ajax. Okay. For your understanding, I prepared the normal one also. I have here normal. This is without Ajax. And I have second one. This is with Ajax, with the command button. Here I have without the command button, only text field. Let me execute the first one. I'm going to say, for example, Bala. The same attribute I'm going to connect here as a value. Value, what I'm going to enter, everywhere it is going to display because same management with the same attribute or variable I'm dealing with. I'm going to press. So everywhere it is displayed. This is one observation. Another observation is the page is reloaded. You see here, it is reloaded. Okay, now this is my normal way of working. Now I am going to work differently. I'm going to say, for example, in this way, Dr. Bala, I'm going to enter here in the Ajax command button. I'm going to say, now, no refreshing. Also, it is not changed the previous value. Where it is reflected? Only the value where I am expecting, there only it is done. I'm going to add some more value. I'm going to press. And I'm going to press again. See, this value is added. So this is using a button. Now I am going to the without button. Whenever you type here, automatically it is coming. You see, whenever you type, automatically coming. So I will show you the code for this one. Already I shown anyhow once again in the code window. Where is it? Ajax here. So I have here designed Ajax inside. You see, first one. This is normal. Where is the normal? Normal is above. This is without Ajax. I have command button. I have input. I have output. So it is going to be refreshed. Reload the page. Second one, using the command button. So I have command button inside. I used to call the name, and I'm going to render the value in the output text. And the third one, without using this, what I shown in that slide, similarly I put here. I hope you understand about this one. So this is all about the design, JSF web design. And we come to the last part of the program, that is working with Hibernate. Let me have a water, please. Okay. So working with the database, actually database can be connected with the various ways. The powerful technology we show for use is JDBC, Java Database Connectivity. It was a very old traditional approach. Still it is available. Many people are using. Sometimes, you know, if you're going to have complex code with the join again, very complex, two or three entities or four entities, you try to connect or update the data or delete the data or select the data. Sometimes, you know, we will have more pain and we may not able to solve here. It is becoming more complex. So due to that reason only, we are going to Hibernate, and meanwhile, I will show other things. After the JDBC, we had a Java data object. After that, we had a Java persistence. And now what is there? We have Hibernate, which includes JDBC, Java data object, persistence all together in Hibernate. So it is more powerful framework. It's again framework. It's one of the framework for dealing with. It's not about preparing a website or designing website, but this framework is prepared for connecting and working with the database. So let us have a brief about Hibernate. It's actually a framework. Okay, every framework has its architecture. So Hibernate is also having its own architecture. I'll show you in the next slide. So it is going to simplify the development of Java application that interacts with the database. When we are having interaction, it's going to simplify the interaction. That's the main purpose. It's going to avoid the complexity. That's the aim. And it implements the JPA, Java Persistence API. Before the Hibernate, we used JPA. That is also one of the feature. And JDO is also another feature. JPA is implemented in Hibernate. That's one important thing. So as a data persistence, for data persistence method, we are going to use, meaning when you're going to prepare a table automatically, JPA will be helpful. And this is actually an open source lightweighted API, which has object relational mapping. We used to call ORM. ORM means object relational mapping, which simplifies data creation, manipulation, and data access aspects. So the duty of the ORM is to create and manipulate your data and work with the data in an easy way. That's the duty of this one. It cares about mapping the data from database table as well as reverse engineering from the database table to the Java class. Either you can create. Let me say once again, you have a Java class with attributes. For example, I have author ID, name, phone number as an attribute I specified here. If I am running min, whatever the class attribute I have, from the based on the class name, I have, for example, contact as a class name. The class name is going to be prepared as a table name. Attributes are going to become as a database fields, column name. And what are the data type that you declared in the class? For example, I say string, that it is going to deal with the database field as a varchar. If I say long, it is going to be a number. If I say date, as a date value. So like that, it is going to be there. And the same way, if you have prepared already, you have a table in the database, that table you want to take back and use it in a, use it as a class name in the Java program. It is called reverse engineering. I'm going to follow the reverse engineering. I will connect the table what is already there. We will automatically generate the class without pain. And the advantages of the Hibernate is actually having more fast in performance, data dependence in the query, and simplifies the complex join. That is the duty of the Hibernate. Now coming to the architecture, it is actually a framework. As I said, every framework has an architecture. The left side sign is actually simplifies simple architecture. Our Java application is there. It is communicating with the object, and the object is dealt with ORM. ORM is connecting with the database. And when you look at the left side sign, it is brief about the architecture. Now you see the object is nothing but a persistent object. Object is nothing but our persistent object. And Hibernate. Hibernate is mapping file as well as we will have configuration file. I will show you how to prepare the configuration. Just we are going to prepare configurations and some few code we are going to write, and automatically it will generate and very easy to work with. And we have database backend. Of course, I have used database as Oracle 12c. Now in the architecture, when you're going to work, we have several elements of on the architecture, which is given in a class name. So the class name are classified here. For example, session factory, session connection provider, transaction factory. Session factory is going to prepare a connection provider. Connection provider, in a sense, it is going to provide a JDBC connection. So here also we are going to use the JDBC. This is why I say in the beginning, Hibernate is using JDBC, JDO, and as well as persistence, I say. So connection provider is going to prepare a JDBC connection and is going to be given to the session factory. Once session factory is prepared, that session factory is going to be given to the session to interact with the application and to deal with the data stores and our data database. So every time we are going to call the session. Once session is ready, we are going to prepare our transaction. The transaction can be prepared by transaction alone. So what is the transaction? It is an atomic unit. So atomic unit is one group of work that you can make it as a transaction. So transaction alone can work, or we can also prepare transaction factory. Transaction factory separately, it is not a mandatory, it's an optional. Once you have prepared transaction factory, that can also be given to transaction. So these are the classes that is there. Even we need not to worry about these classes. This code will be generated as a utility separately. Now I'm going to the steps to create Hibernate. Apart from the design, we have 7 steps here. So among the 7 steps, we are going to work with the highlighted 6th point and 7th point as coding part. So create a contact DAO, prepare the control Java, controller Java. These two only we are going to make a code. Even in the controller part, partially we are going to produce, and system will produce half of them. And contact only we are going to fully work. Contact DAO only we are going to prepare. All other steps are going to be automatically done. Let's look at the configuration. First, we are going to have this is our based on our understanding. I classify or segregated the points. For example, I say configuration. I have said preparing entity or entity bin, preparing model, preparing controller. These are all for our name check only, for our understanding only. It is not mandated to work with the same way. If you are going to segregate the file like this, we will have a clear understanding. Otherwise, everything you are going to put together, there is no issue at all. And how you are going to work is, you need a configuration file. First is, we have to prepare configuration file, and we have to use reverse engineering to find the schema and the table name. And third, we are going to prepare POJO class. That means from the database table, we are going to prepare as a class. So this class, it is going to be automatically prepared. Okay, everything is automatic. I will share the steps, and the class code will be automatically generated. Once it is prepared, and we are going to prepare a utility to prepare the session. This is to prepare the session. Once the session is ready, we are going to prepare the DAO. Going to work with the code operation, create, read, update, delete. All these operations we are going to write here. And those operations we are going to call here. Calling work only our part. other getter setter constructor, you know, automatically prepared. Now, to in order to work with this, we have to right click on the project source package, and we will find a new file, and you will find a new window in which you will have a category here. In the category, we are going to find the Hibernate. In the Hibernate, you will find all the file types which gives you to work with the configuration files. You see configure wizard, reverse engineering, mapping bojo, Hibernate utility, everything. Now I will show you the same thing here. I prepared as another I have prepared another project here. Okay, here I have one index file which has a data table. It's going to show the data table here, and which provides a link to create a new contact. I'm going to have a contact in which I will show you first of all about this one. I have a start user here in the Oracle database, which has a contact table. And you see the contact table, we have author ID, person name, phone number, three fields only, because in order to simplify the code, to make you understand, I have a few fields only with one table only I'm working here. Okay, so this field I'm going to connect in the Hibernate. So for that reason, I am having three fields only. I'm having data table. So I have list of values. I used to show the value for author ID. I have person name here. I have phone number here. So I shown here. And if you want to delete, update, I put it in another column. For deletion, updation, I put it in another column, which calls the action over here. So this code might be written in the controller. I'll show you this part. Okay, now the other one, new contact. I designed the new contact. When you press the new contact, here I'm getting the input for new contact. So I'm getting author ID for here. I'm getting the person name. I'm getting the phone number. And I used to call the create. So this is going to be connecting the controller. When you press the button, it's going to call the controller with a create. So the create might have called with the DAO. The same way, same similar code, but I'm going to use the another one, update. That's another page. For update only, I'm having another page. Similarly, same design, I'm calling the action as update. That's all. And these are the design part I have. I'm coming to the source package. I have a configuration file here. So whatever that I described in the slide, I have two configuration wizard and reverse engineering. This is the controller part. For that, I prepared a separate package. All these are non-mandatory. For our understanding only, I segregated. I have controller. Controller means it is actually a managed bin. So a managed bin, which is going to talk with the DAO. So I have managed bin here. It is given an object name as C. I used to have session bin, for example. I have a list of value to load in the data table. I have getter setter method. And here, I'm going to have a code operation. I'm going to show in the slide. Don't worry about it. And I have entity here. I have model here. Okay. So now I will show you the other part. Okay. Now coming to this, we are going to prepare, first of all, configuration with the Hibernate CFG file. So in the Hibernate category, we are going to choose configuration wizard, and we are going to say next. When you say next, it will come like this. So it will come like this, first of all, this first window. Once you choose next, and then it is asking you to select the database. So it is asking you to select the database. I'm using schema. Automatically it takes the driver for this one. The dialog driver, something is assigned automatically. Don't worry about this one. And once it is done, it automatically generates a code for the database. Okay, you can see in the XML file. And in addition to this configuration, we have to add another two code. For example, there is a SQL, we have to say true. There is a current session context, we have to say thread. This you can type directly in the XML part, or we can assign through the miscellaneous property and through the configuration property. Let me show you this one. go here to the configuration file. Let me close all other things. Configuration file. You will see the source code. You click on the source, you can see able to see the source. Source is here. Come back to the design. So the design is connected here. In the miscellaneous part, we are going to add here. It is I already added. You have to add it. I will show you once again. And we have to add in the configuration properties as SQL. These two we have to do. Or we have to type these two last. So this last two will not be there. These two will not be there. We have to add it. Otherwise, when you run. Selecting the next page, it will load the database table that you have. Of course, I deleted all this table already available because it was taking time to work again with that. So I put only two table. It is actually previous screenshot I took. Okay, the table available we are showing here. I have clicked here and I added a contact table which has three attribute, other ID, name, phone number only. Okay, so once you did mean, the XML code will be generated like this. It includes the schema name and contact name. Once the schema name, contact name is ready, and we are going to proceed to the next to prepare the entity. So we are going to prepare three different packages or the folder. We are going to prepare three different packages. Right click and then say new folder or package. Just prepare controller entity model. This for our identification purpose only. So we are segregating ourselves with. Just prepare. After that, after preparing this, I will go to the entity part. Entity part, I will just prepare a right click new. I will go to the new file, again choose Hibernate. Now I'm going to choose Pojo database, Pojo from database, meaning database structure is already ready. From the database structure, I'm going to take the class. I'm going to convert the class for that reason. Once you are clicked this one, it is going to automatically connect the configuration file what you had previously. Previously, we had prepared a Hibernate CFG file and a Hibernate reverse engineering file. These two files automatically connect here. Once it is connected, and then what will happen, automatically, once you say finish, automatically one contact HBM XML file will be prepared. That's why I'm prepared separately as entity, okay? One file is prepared because it is from the window what we did, that is prepared here. The other one is contact.java class file is prepared. So this class is based on the database table what we have there. So what are the attributes? Three attributes are there. So three variable might have declared, constructor prepared, getter setter method prepared. Everything is prepared on behalf of us. Okay. Now, this is the class prepared. Okay, class string. Other ID, string name, phone number I had, so it is automatically declared phone number with the long. So constructor for the contact is empty constructor, parameter, single parameter, multiple parameter. And we have all getter setter method here. And we now go to the next one, that is model package or folder. In this we are going to prepare Hibernate utility Java. This will be will make you session for the program. How are you going to make main? We are going to again prepare on the new file, go to the Hibernate, and we are going to choose Hibernate.java class, and we are going to give the name here, say finish. It automatically prepare the code. Okay, you can see here Hibernate utility class. Once it is ready, so this class just will give you preparing a session for the Hibernate. Okay. This also automatically generated. Now we are going to work with the contact DAO class. This is the one we are going to prepare. So we are going to prepare this, remember. So contact.java, DAO Java, we are preparing code operation. Code understand, create, read, update, delete. So it's actually easy to work with this. First of all, I'm going to show the common code. So common code in a sense, the code what we had in the code is, first thing is we have to prepare the session. So I have session, one object is, Hibernate class what we prepared previously, the Hibernate here. Hibernate get session factory, get session. So get the current session that is assigned in the yes attribute, yes object. Okay. And once session is ready, we are going to begin the transaction, and something we are going to do, and we are going to commit the transaction. If successfully done, transaction is successful, the operation what you do in the middle highlighted area done, and then we are going to commit the transaction. If there is any error in the trackage block in middle, we are going to have a rollback. Automatically it will take rollback. So this red line code are very common to all the operation, all the code operation, remember. And now I am in find all operation, in which I am finding all the element. I am going to list all the contacts. So I am prepared a list contact as a list object here with array list, and in which I am going to assign yes. Yes is my object in which I am preparing a criteria. Criteria is from the Hibernate. I am representing the contact class with, I am showing the list. It means it is showing all the list of value going to be loaded on the list. And if you call this method in the controller, it immediately shows all the value. Some situations are there to find a particular item or a particular person. For that reason, we prepared, for example, get person by ID. For that, I have passed the parameter here, ID, and it returns a contact. So same way, I have session, beginning the transaction, committing, if any problem, rollback. Only thing is, we are going to have middle of the transaction and committing transaction, some code. So I'm going to have load contact class, which what do you want to find? You are going to say what do you want to find? What is the class that you are working? This loading data will be converted as a typecast, and it is going to be loaded whatever the object that you created. This object is going to be returned, because if you are going to find any person, that will be returned for that reason. If you call get person of this person, yes, we found, it's going to be returned by contact. Now coming to the create contact. Create contact is my method. I'm going to call the contact inside. Only thing is, the parameter every time you are going to say for create, delete, update, all these things are very common. Only the method in the inside of the transaction we are going to change. Okay, all other red lines are the common. Okay, I'm passing which contact class contact is C. What I'm going to say, my session object, yes, save, I'm going to say C. C, C is what? Other ID, name, phone number, all the three are inside. So all the three will be saved in the database. Okay. Same way, if you want to update, what do you want to update? Update the contact. What you are going to say? Yes dot update of C. C is what? Contact. All other things are same. Similarly, we are going to have delete. What do you want to delete? I'm going to delete the contact. Which contact? What you are giving the parameter? That contact. Okay, delete that contact. So these are all the very common, easy to work. And finally, we come to the controller. Controller class is a manager bean. So manager bean, any object you can give, eager. To make active, you can put, you know, about scoped concept. I'm giving session scope because I'm going to use multiple. I have a contact controller here. In order to get all the lists, I have a list contact here. And I have a contact class. Because every time I need a contact, so I prepared a contact class here. So this is the one which is going to give the value for all my calls. So I have a code method here in this page to edit the value. I say contact of what is the value, this dot C, I say whatever the object I created, that will be the present, this represent the current object. What is the current object? I say this dot C. What C is there? What object is there? That's it. That is my current object. This object you edit it, and I ask you to go for update. I ask to return the value. So this is the navigation I gave. So this navigation we already prepared in the facelets. I come to now update, create, delete. In all I'm going to prepare the contact DAO object in which I will call the object CD dot. CD is a DAO object in which I'm going to say the present object. What is the present object to update? Whichever the present object is loaded in the manager bean, that will be getting updated, and asked to return the page to the, after updating the value, page will be returned to the index. That means home page. Again, similarly, create is going to create the new, what is available in the present manager bean. So what is the current contact is available? Update it, create, okay? And I'm not redirecting it because I provided the button over there to go back to the home page, because user may be expecting to add a more item. For that reason, I'm not given a return page here. And delete, I have similar aspects. I'm calling delete, I'm going to delete the same item here. So delete, I will deal with the home page itself, so no return page. And for finding element, I say get item, I'm preparing again DAO, I say, call find all the item. So I'm not calling here in this find for a specific person. If you want, we can also write that one. Apart from this, we have all getter setter method here. I put few things here. All getter setter method. This is for getting elements. Almost we have reached the things. I will show you how it is working, and I will also show you how to configure the files. Okay. First of all, let me show you how it is working. Later we will go to configure the file. Oh, this is the page I have here. So let me refresh it. Maybe I load a long back. Okay. So already I have two different record. Okay. Let me go for example, I have here Bala is one, another one name, some simple sample record I have. If you are going to add the new record, click on new, and you are going to give an ID. Maybe you can say any ID, 987654, something I'm giving. Maybe I say Dr. Karthik. I say some number, it's not your number, Dr. Kadhi, okay? I'm going to insert the record. Once it is inserted, it says your record is added. If you want, you can go back to the contact or you can add some more record, okay? Let me see the contact list, go back to the index. So Dr. Kadhi again is added. If you are going to delete, for example, I have an ABCD record, you want to delete it, I say I will click on this one. Are you sure want to delete it? If you say okay, it will be deleted. Cancel means it won't delete. I say click, okay. Then I click here. Yes, it is going to delete. I have my name without solution here. I'm going to give here for updation. So let me go here. I will just add, for example, I say Dr. Bala. Then I will update. Yes, of course, it is updated. This is the way that I have worked. Now what I will do is I will show how to configure the file. Let me show you. Then almost we are coming to the end of the session. For that reason, what I will do, I will not disturb this code, where I'm going to just simply right click and copy the code. I will copy the new project. I will give a new name, for example, JSF hibernate new. I'll copy. So this is the new file. We have all the things. Okay, let me delete all the things, all the configuration. I'm going to delete. Delete, yes. I'm going to delete the entity. I'm going to delete the model. I'm going to delete the model. One thing, DAO I deleted. Excuse me, I'll copy from this one. DAO also I deleted. I need the DAO, no? So sorry, I will take the DAO only. Model DAO. Okay, DAO only is expected to make a code, no? So I will copy here, refactor. I put this one. All other we are going to make as a configuration. Now we go to the configuration. So how do you going to make a configuration? So we have design part, and we have controller, and we have the what do you call DAO part here. Now let me choose the package. Right click over here, new, then choose others. Go to the new file, new here, and I will choose the hibernate here. You see here all the hibernate configuration files are there, okay? Now let me choose the configuration wizard. Let me proceed this. And you can see here the database. I'm going to connect the Oracle Scott. Say finish, okay. Once we completed this, immediately go to the miscellaneous properties, add the session contacts as a thread. Otherwise, during the running time, we face the problem. And in the configuration connection properties, we're going to add SQL as true. Okay, after that, simply save. Once it is saved, close it. Now we go to the next one. New, again, others, to the Hibernate. And choose reverse engineering. Just proceed next. Of course, it is going to bring the Oracle database table here. It takes a few minutes. Okay, it's almost done. Yeah, otherwise I deleted all the table yesterday. Otherwise it would take more time, even sometime hanging. The employee table, department table and all I deleted. I kept only two table. I was working with the other table also. So there is a contact table. I'm going to move to the right side and I'm going to say finish. So now you can see the code. It is connected our schema. It is connected our schema and the table name. Now we go to the entity. We are going to prepare the entity. Then new, others. And again, we are going to choose Hibernate. We are going to select Pojo. Mean we are going to prepare based on the table, the entity class is going to be prepared. I say I already clicked, then it's taking time, few seconds. Because it should be connected to database field, no? So it will be connecting to the previous two, the Hibernate CFG and Hibernate. Who is making all these things? Some screen is coming with some other things. Okay, it's connected to the previous configuration. Here you can see Hibernate CFG and Hibernate Reverse Engineering, it is connected. You are going to say simply finish. It automatically prepares our contact class based on the table that we have. Contact is our class. So contact class Java is prepared now. We will see here in the entity. Contact HBM file is created, contact Java file is prepared. So this is based on our table. See, we are not prepared. Contact certain method, attribute, everything is prepared based on our table. And now in the final, with the model, I'm going to prepare the Hibernate utility. Go back, this is the last configuration. Hibernate utility, next, and now you simply I give Hibernate, not new hyperlink, Hibernate, just use the same name I used previously with this one. So without modifying that, it should connect now. So done, our work is done, now we can run it. We can run it, it is ready. Now I'm running the newly prepared Hibernate code. So all our configuration is done. Apart from the design and apart from the DAO and the controller. Now we can see here, this one, this is a new, Hibernate new. Okay, it will work in the same way. For example, you go to the new one, I will give sample, some sample. Okay. So contact is inserted. Yeah, it works well. So only thing is configuration. So the Hibernate is providing configuration and providing the classes to connect with our program. Okay, almost all my presentation is over. Now I come to the conclusion. So, so in this session, you would understand the basics of JSF with the Hibernate framework, with all JSF UI component, and even I can also show the other one. One thing. I'm sorry. Before going to this one, excuse me. One thing I already prepared. I forgot to show you. In the previous, I would like to show only one thing, especially about the component shoot. No. Component should, I'll just refresh it because it's not, the session might have been ended. Okay, I'll go to prime phases. I prepared one prime phase code here. Let me open the previous program once again. Yeah, it's opened here. Okay, so this is the prime phase. Okay, so I can come back to the slide where we had here all the yes, it will give more understanding. Yeah, this one. I said I was discussing about the components. You know, there are so many components. But for example, I would like to show the prime phases here. So the component suits are giving additional user interface component with the different look and appearance as well as the features. For example, I prepared one page by using the prime phases. The prime phases have charts. You see, chart is prepared here. I have used a text field. You see, text field is looking differently. I used a date control. This date control is not available in the normal JSF. There is a time clock. I have shown clock graph. So these are all only example for prime phase component. So if you are going to look at the other composite component, component shoot, you will find more attractive pages with additional design, additional controls, another additional UI control to enhance your web application. Okay, so this I did for you for your understanding. Let me go to the conclusion. So what you have seen is JSF framework with Hibernate framework we have seen, and the JSF you found all basic ideas and how to work with, how to design facelets, all components, and how to work with manager beans, what is the importance of manager beans, and converters, validators, importance of converters, validators, and able to connect with the database using Hibernate. So I try to cover all. This is full stack, okay? Full stack development. I can say as I, within one, I don't know how long I was taking. I tried to install this JSF Hibernate in your mind. And I would like to thank you, all of you, for your patience, your time. And I would like to thank Bishop Habir College principal, HOD of Computer Science, the organizing secretary, Dr. B. Karthikeyan, is my friend, and for all the participants, thank you very much. Thank you once again. If you have doubt, please, you can proceed. Okay, and for your knowledge, I put some references here. So for JSF technology, you'll find in Oracle site itself, you'll find many pages. I connected here, JSF pages you can find here. Specification you can find in the GitHub. Hibernate, you can find it in the Hibernate.org. NetBean, you will find a NetBean tool from here. I suggested this digital Java EE7 web application development written by Pilgrim and Peter, and another one, Mastering Java 2.2. These two books will be more of our benefit to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Dr. Bala.
Thank you, sir.
Very effective presentation. I think it will be very useful for the persons.
Yeah, I hope so.
12:30, so the time is now overrun.
Oh, sorry, I took more time.
No problem, sir. So, dear participants, we are unable to give all the persons to ask the questions. So, we plan to give only 3 persons already. Who all are interested to ask the questions, please raise your hand. Already, Dr. R. Vadivel is raised hand. I just enable that person. Please ask the question to the resource person.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Dr. R. Vadivel, please.
Yeah, Dr. Sir, please.
Fine. I think it's not available.
I'm not hearing anything from him.
Okay, there is no problem. The another person is available. Dashini Selvakumar. I am going to unmute you. please. Please unmute and ask the question to the resource person.
Yeah, please unmute them.
Okay, Dashni Selakumar is also not available. Okay, I think okay, there is no person to ask a question. There is no problem. If you are having any questions, please post in the Telegram as well as send the mail to us. Dr. Bala Kandaripani will answer to your questions. Okay. So once again, I want to thank.
They can also drop their question in the chat box, right? You can see.
Yeah. Well, there is no option for that one.
Okay.
If they want to ask a question, they have to raise a hand.
Okay. They can raise the hand.
I think the Vadivel and Dashni Selvakumar, the both is not available. Okay, there is no problem. Suppose if they are having any questions, please post in the Telegram group as well as through mail. So Dr. Bala Dandayadupani, the research person, will answer to your questions. Okay. The feedback form is available in the chat box as well as in your YouTube link. Okay, it will be available up to another 20 minutes. Please fill all the things. So once again, I would like to thank our resource person, Dr. Bala Dandayadupani, for giving a very excellent presentation. I think it will be very useful for them. And I would like to thank our principal and HOD and the college management and all other things. Okay, thank you. Finally, I would thank our participants. Okay, thank you. I'm going to shut down the session.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.